everyone. Today we'll be covering the key elements of setting up VR zones in timeshare. We'll focus on, first, general overview, format, sizes, and number of headsets. Two, interior surfaces, optimizing walls, ceiling, and floor. Third, component of the VR zone, TV, tablets, headsets, stands, controllers, and batteries. Four, hidden yet integral parts, key details that ensure smooth business operation. Let's get started.
We have 21 headsets across 8 VR zones, 4 zones for 2 players, each measuring 5.5 by 2.7 meters, 3 zones for 4 players, each measuring 5.5 by 5.5 meters, and 1 zone for 1 player, a demo zone for a short 5-minute promo session. However, we found that it's neither necessary nor smart use of space, as customers usually come for a full experience already.
The ideal size for a VR zone is 3 by 3 meters per player. Creating a larger space offers no real benefit as it won't be used effectively. However, ensuring the zone is not too small is crucial. If the space is smaller than 2.5 by 2.5 meters, players will frequently see the boundary grid, which disrupts immersion. The only way to avoid this issue in such a small zone is if the player remains in the center at all times, something only experienced and loyal customers might manage. But let's be honest, the majority of players are newcomers and they need a seamless experience.
When designing a VR zone, it's crucial to calculate the space from the player's central position and consider their movement, especially during active play when they swing their arms. Take a look at 2.5 by 2.5 space. The yellow square represents the space where the player can move freely without frequently seeing the boundary grid. It's already by far larger than a 2 by 2 meter zone. Now, compare it to 3 by 3 meter space. You can clearly see the difference. Proper measurements are key to designing an efficient VR zone layout while ensuring an immersive and enjoyable experience for players. If the zone is too small, players will constantly trigger the boundary grid, which disrupts immersion and leads to frustration. This is not only result in a negative experience for them, but also risks losing customers for you.
As you can see, it follows a mixed format. Open and spacious, this allows non-playing visitors to watch the companions and capture content for social media. Closed enough to create a sense of safety and privacy for the players. This balance enhances both gameplay experience and social aspect of VR.
Now, let's talk about the walls. Initially, we considered using posters for decoration. However, we realized that creating numerous unique artwork patterns for stable headset tracking would be impractical. Additionally, achieving the desired visual effect would require specialized lighting, significantly increasing power consumption, making it costly and insufficient solution. While newer headsets have improved tracking, occasional tracking loss and unintended reconfiguration of the VR zone to another part of the physical space, where the only solution is to reboot the headset, can still disrupt the experience. That's why we choose a design with simple geometric shapes. This approach enhances tracking while maintaining a visually appealing look. The too large and too small walls here are constructed using a combination of drywall, foam rubber, and felt panels. Here is a breakdown of each layer.
Drywall. Affordable, easy to work with, and ideal for hidden wiring. Important, always hide all wires for both safety and clean appearance. In the future, we plan to switch to chipboard, which is more durable, allows for better structured wiring system, and is easier to replace if damaged. Foam rubber, 1 centimeter thick, essential for safety. Players can get carried away and accidentally hit the walls. This padding minimizes the risk of serious injuries and helps protect your business from potential legal issues. Felt panels. These provide several advantages. They are easy to replace if damaged, feature unique tracking patterns, and are affordable, customizable, and available in various colors. By carefully designing our walls, we ensure a safe, immersive, and visually appealing VR experience for customers. Additionally, each layer contributes to soundproofing. When VR venue operates more than 10 headsets and runs at full capacity, it can get noisy and chaotic. To ensure maximum comfort, it's crucial to design your VR zones in a way that minimizes and neutralizes the sound.
Returning to tracking. In certain position, any headset can lose tracking. When a player gets too close to the entrance where there is a lot of open space, the headset needs a reference point to maintain stability. This is where the floor and ceiling play a key role. To improve tracking reliability, we added extra felt pendants to the ceiling. If you spend 3 minutes walking around the zone and you believe you've done enough testing, don't be fooled. Real gameplay is far more dynamic. Player movements vary significantly, and what seems stable in a quick test will not hold up during active play. Plan ahead when designing your VR zone to ensure a seamless and reliable experience. A high ceiling with proper ventilation is crucial for comfortable VR experience. Ceiling height directly affects air volume in the room. The more air volume, the better the airflow, ensuring a cooler, more pleasant environment. To prevent overheating, the ceiling should be at least 3.5 meters high, allowing heat to rise and disperse properly. VR hardware and active players generate significant heat, and if the ceiling is too low, 2.5, 2.7 meters, warm air accumulates, making the space stuffy and uncomfortable. Without sufficient ceiling height, designing an effective ventilation system becomes nearly impossible.
Proper lighting is crucial for tracking, ensuring players are fully illuminated without disturbing other guests or causing discomfort. To achieve this, we use black felt around the perimeter of the VR zone, which helps control light flow and soundproofing. The lighting inside the VR zone is independent of the rest of the venue's lighting, allowing for individual regulation and fine-tuning based on the specific needs. To enhance tracking quality without overwhelming the environment, we plan to integrate infrared lighting. This will provide just enough illumination for optimal headset tracking while maintaining a discreet atmosphere. For players who prefer complete darkness for comfort, they will have the option to disable regular lighting entirely. Once the headset is removed, standard lighting will gradually activate to ensure a smooth transition. While this feature is still under development and not yet a priority, since most of our visitors are newcomers, it will be particularly beneficial for regular customers who come during evening hours. This adjustment will create a more comfortable and personalized experience to returning guests.
Now about the floor. Currently we use vinyl panels, but we have encountered two issues. They scratch easily and they are difficult to reinstall. We plan to switch to office vinyl panels, which offer better scratch resistance and are much easier to replace if damaged and add more patterns.
Each VR zone is equipped with a TV that serves two main purposes. First, displaying trailers of our VR experiences when the zone is unoccupied, encouraging players to try yet another experience. Second, showcasing real-time gameplay from each headset, providing the live glimpse of the action. These functions help attract players to explore more VR experiences while also promoting additional services, such as pizza or drinks. Although there was initial concern that showing escape room gameplay on the TV might spoil the puzzles, we found that it does not impact players' decision to participate. Instead, it sparks curiosity and excitement.
All equipment should be placed in the corners, not in the center of the zone. Players typically stay in the center or venture to the edges and almost never to corners, making the corners the safest spot to avoid accidents. This is why we didn't set up zone for six players. The placement of the components wasn't suitable for such a configuration. In each corner, we place a tablet, a headset on a stand, controllers and their stands, Boba VR chargers. This setup is clean, space efficient, and organized.
During our research, we found that many venues place the headsets on the floor, which are then put directly onto players' faces, raising hygiene concerns. Hygiene is a popular topic in Google reviews, and it's clear that customers are sensitive to it. It is crucial to understand that adults who often spend the most money want to enter a clean, well-maintained venue to enjoy their experience. They'll gladly pay the high price if the venue meets these expectations.
The tablet plays a crucial role in enhancing the player experience and facilitating interaction with the venue system. It serves multiple functions, with some features still in development. Its key tasks include grants access to unique player profiles, allowing the system to automatically set the individual IPD for each player, track gameplay for history for future customization. For example, upcoming games may allow players to save artifacts or progress for their next visit, enables players to adjust volume, request staff assistance, locate their designated spot. Overall, the tablet enhances automation, simplifying operations and minimizing staff involvement.
Next up is the headset. We received multiple questions from our partners asking about the best standalone headset for LBVR, especially as the industry shifts away from wired solutions. Recognizing this trend, we began extensive research to identify the most capable option. When we launched TimeShift, we carefully evaluated the available headset and chose the Pico 4 Enterprise for its automation, flexibility, and performance. Now we are moving forward and have already placed orders for the Pico 4 Ultra Enterprise as our next step. Throughout extensive testing, we found that Pico 4 Ultra Enterprise to be one of the most capable wireless solutions available today, offering excellent tracking, a competitive price, and most importantly, seamless automation for business operations. One limitation is the lack of automatic IPD adjustment, but here's a spoiler, we are actively working on the solution. That said, relying on a single headset model is never a long-term strategy. We are already planning to introduce alternative headsets in the future, ensuring business stability and minimizing potential risks as the industry evolves.
How we updated the headset facial cover. We replaced the original facial cover with a more comfortable plastic one, as the original design caused headaches due to excessive pressure on the vein. The issue is also present in Oculus. Fabric covers. We created reusable fabric covers that are swapped for each player and washed afterward. However, we are developing a custom solution that will be even more comfortable and effective. In my hands is a prototype we are designing specifically for Pico. We also plan to introduce a headset mask dispenser stocked with new covers along with a bin for used ones. Ideally, replacing a cover and cleaning the lenses should take no more than a minute for game masters.
Here we have Bubble VR battery solution, which we have been very satisfied with. However, we plan to phase it out. The rubber adapter and the battery plus 370 grams make the headset noticeably heavier and less comfortable. The setup shrinks the headset size by approximately 1 cm, making it tight for users with the larger hats. No auto-resume. Once the headset reaches 100%, Bubble VR stops charging and does not restart automatically when the battery level drops again. That is why, spoiler alert, we are developing our own charging system, which will be much more comfortable to use. And another thing, Bubble VR supports only 8 to 10 volts charging, while we've developed an 18 volt solution, the maximum supported by Pico. Headsets should always remain fully charged at 100%. When the battery runs low, the headset starts malfunctioning, and it's not always obvious why. To prevent this, when the battery drops to 90%, the admin panel notifies the game master to recharge them. You'll notice numbers on the controllers and the headset. In the future, we plan to add laser engraved QR code to track headsets if they are moved outside of the dedicated VR zone. So far, this hasn't been an issue, which is why it wasn't our top priority, but it's always better to be prepared.
Now, the headset stand. You might think it's just a simple plastic stand, but no, it has two hidden yet crucial features. Hidden, the stand warms up the headset to prevent lens fogging on cold mornings, and cooling and refreshing. After using the headset, the built-in ventilation system cools it down, ensuring it's ready for the next player.
Moving on to the controllers, they should hang neatly on their stands, clearly indicating which is left and which is right. Constantly replacing batteries is not the most eco-friendly solution, so we have switched to the rechargeable battery packs. However, this also requires regular charging, and honestly, are quite pricey as they take a lot of time for game masters to manage, something we want to avoid. In the future, we plan to integrate a custom solution that will allow controllers to charge directly through the stands, ensuring they always remain powered, with the original battery pack serving as the backup.
When the venue operates a small number of headsets, these details may seem minor. But as the number of headsets increases and consequently the complexity of the operation does as well, managing everything manually becomes increasingly difficult. This is where the process automation becomes crucial. Imagine a large group of students arriving on a non-commercial day, Wednesday, and finding that your controllers or headset are not fully charged. What should have been a great opportunity for revenue and building loyal customers could quickly turn into chaos and a negative experience. The key idea is simple. Addressing issues takes time, and any delays affect the customer experience. By proactively identifying potential problems, we can minimize downtime and ensure that the customer experience remains seamless without any issues.
Our PCs are securely mounted onto the ceiling to prevent theft and keep them out of reach to avoid damage. They generate significant heat, which is why we position them at the ceiling to ensure that hot air accumulates at the top layer. Additionally, we distributed them throughout the facility to prevent overheating in any one concentrated area. If all of the PCs were placed in one spot, they could quickly overheat and potentially cause a fire. Staff members don't need direct access to the PCs. They are remotely powered on and off. In case of emergencies, we can connect to them via wired connection. For optimal performance, we allocate one PC per headset and an additional PC for the video display on the TV. To ensure stable performance, we avoid running OBS on the gaming PCs. Instead, we use a compact $25 external video capture device, which operates automatically to prevent content lag. Regardless of whether the zone is designed for two or for four players, there is always one dedicated PC for the TV.
Now, let's talk about our camera system and why it's essential. Each gaming zone is equipped with a surveillance camera. These affordable cameras allow us to review club activity from the past 30 to 60 days, ensuring safety and enabling quick resolution of any incidents. A visible sign at the entrance informs visitor about video monitoring. Running a high-quality venue requires significant investment, making security a top priority. Our discreet black cameras blend into the environment while providing reliable oversight. We have around 15 cameras dedicated to staff management and general venue monitoring. In addition to security cameras, we have separate ones that capture gameplay in color and high quality for social media and advertising purposes. While this feature isn't active yet, we plan to launch it soon. This setup ensures both security and future promotional opportunities.
To launch a truly successful VR venue, every detail must be meticulously considered. VR is a premium entertainment experience, and people are willing to pay for it only if it meets the highest standards. Given the substantial investment required for expensive hardware, a prime location with high rent, and skilled staff, operational costs are inherently high. These core expenses are non-negotiable, meaning ticket prices cannot be set too low without compromising revenue and long-term sustainability. A low-price strategy is simply not viable. To justify a premium ticket price, every aspect of the customer experience must embody excellence, from the technology and environment to the service and immersion. When every element aligns with top-tier standards, customers will recognize the value and will be willing to pay for it, ensuring profitability and sustained success. The venue setup should be functional, safe, and visually striking. High-quality materials, thoughtful layouts, and aesthetically pleasing designs will inspire customers to take photos, generating organic marketing and social media buzz.
Operational efficiency is crucial. Automation through smart software and hardware solutions will streamline processes and reduce the workload on game masters, ensuring smooth operation even in larger venues. It's essential to anticipate potential equipment failures and have backup solutions in place for quick swaps to minimize downtime. Hygiene plays a key role as well. No one wants to wear a dirty headset, so seamless, efficient cleaning protocols are a must to maintain the highest level of cleanliness and comfort for all players. A functional, beautiful, and clean VR zone isn't just an option, it's a necessity. Don't cut corners. Create a space that's not only worth visiting, but worth sharing. When everything works smoothly and the experience is unforgettable, you won't just attract customers, you will build a loyal community. Thank you for watching. Leave your thoughts in the comments below. We would love to hear from you.